This is TK Coleman, and you're watching another episode of TK's Two Cents. Today, we're going to talk about loud voices and brilliant work. Let's dive right in with tweet number one. The loudest voices aren't necessarily the most logical voices. Making a lot of noise isn't the same thing as making a sound argument. I want you to imagine that you have a friend who's really excited about this new song they heard, right? And they play the song and they say, check this song out, man, it's so good. And they play the song and you listen to it all the way through and you say, yeah, it's not my thing. I don't really like it. And they say, oh, okay, let me try something here. And they push repeat to play the song again and they turn the volume up a little bit more. And you listen to the same song that you didn't like the first time and you say, yeah, man, nothing changed for me. I don't really like it. And they say, oh, okay, well, one more second. And then they turn the volume all the way up. And they say, now what do you think? And you say, look, man, it's still the same song. Playing it louder does not make it more lovable. What does that illustrate? An increase in volume is not the same thing as an increase in value. We all know this. We all recognize this with any other example. And yet it can be so hard to see when it comes to the realm of rhetoric, public discourse, and argumentation. There are people out there that are very intimidating. There are people out there that have the power to bully you, make you afraid when they talk. They know how to interrupt you. They know how to out-talk you. They know how to out-shout you. And it can feel like, oh my gosh, maybe this person is so right. But here's the thing. You cannot base your life decisions on the bravado of another person. You must base your life decisions on your own convictions and on your own understanding of what is true. Other people's understanding of the universe will do you no good if you don't take the time to think for yourself. And just because someone else is intimidating, just because someone else is loud, just because someone has the ability to shout you down, it does not mean that their ideas are worth living by. It does not mean that your life is going to get better if you take their advice. It does not mean that they know what they are talking about. Either what a person says is based on fact or it's not. Either a person is willing to provide evidence for their views or they are not. If they're not, it doesn't matter how loud they're willing to speak. You've got to live your life based on what is true, not based on how confident other people feel in their ability to outshout you. Let's go to tweet number two. What if your most brilliant piece of work is on the other side of that mediocre piece of work that you're afraid to ever be seen doing? My question for you is, are you bad enough to be good? And are you good enough to be bad? Well, what do you mean by that, TK? What do you mean? Well, the only way to get good at something is to be bad at it first. The only way to get to great is to walk through the pain of mediocrity. One of my favorite quotes about learning comes from Chalmers Brothers, who said, learning is the process of doing what you don't know how to do while you don't know how to do it. In order to learn something, you got to start with the honest acknowledgement of the fact that you don't know what you're doing right now. You don't know what you're talking about right now, but you're going to get there. You're going to get there through study. You're going to get there through practice. But in order to get there, you have to give up your need to always be seen as someone who is in the know, to always be seen as someone who's got it together. In order to be good, you got to be willing to let the world look at you when there is a high probability that the world will say, wow, you're pretty bad at that. You're pretty bad at that. The people who have those kinds of big egos, who can't stand to be criticized, who can't stand to receive constructive feedback, they never improve their skill set. They never make it to the next level. But the person who sets their ego aside and says, hey, I want to be great so badly that I'm willing to try this when I won't be very good. I'm willing to try this when it's going to be responded to with constructive criticism. Those are the people that make it to that next level. Be bad enough to be good, and be good enough to be bad. Be so good in your ability to strive for that next level that you're willing to let the world see you when you're bad. Let's go to, that is tweet number two. That is tweet number two. Hey, that's TK's Two Cents on loud voices and brilliant work. Check it out. Please hit the like button and the subscribe button if you're watching on YouTube. If you're listening to it audio, please subscribe to the podcast so you can hear these sessions every week. feel free to leave a comment letting me know your additional thoughts, any questions you might have, or anything you'd like to hear me talk about in the future. Always up for suggestions and feedback. And in the meantime, pay more attention to logic than loudness, and make sure you give yourself the chance to do brilliant work by being willing to do bad work at first. All right, everybody, peace out. That's TK's Two Cents.